Some people used to mock former President George W. Bush, saying that he wasn't the sharpest tool in the shed. If you need proof, they could point to that picture of him holding a children's book upside down. I mean, you can't make this stuff up. Well, actually, you can. And someone did. Here's the real photo. And this kind of trickery didn't start with Photoshop. Phony photos and doctored videos have been around for a long time. Check out this iconic image of Lincoln from the 1860s. Looks heroic, huh? Well, it's really only part Lincoln. His head, to be exact. The body belongs to John C. Calhoun, who, fun fact, was a big-time racist and slavery proponent. This print wasn't outed as fake for almost a century. And today, we have so-called deepfakes. Deepfakes are videos that have been manipulated using fancy AI technology. This tech can scale, rotate, or splice videos and images together to create new videos that can be very different from the original. And social media platforms like YouTube help to spread this kind of fake media, partially because of the ease and speed of sharing. But so far, they aren't really owning their big part in this era of deepfakes. Since according to the Pew Research Center, 85% of teens use YouTube and 2/3 of all Americans get at least some of their news from social media platforms.
We're entering an era in which our enemies can make it look like anyone is saying anything at any point in time, even if they would never say those things.
This fake PSA got a ton of media coverage back in 2018. Jordan Peele and BuzzFeed created it, reproducing President Obama's voice and image. While Peele's fake isn't perfect, it's good enough to freak out anyone worried about the spread of fakes in the near future. So in this era of deep fakes, how can you tell fact from fiction? AI is making the manipulation of audio and video cheaper and more sophisticated. And as this AI becomes more open source, it's more accessible to more people who can then create more believable videos. This tech can do some pretty wonderful things. It can help you create awesome artwork and make some pretty good CGI scenes without a Hollywood studio. It can even add Nicolas Cage to any movie scene. Sorry, let that sink in for a second. And look, entertainment and satire are fine. Nobody wants to stop Photoshop battles on Reddit or get rid of hilarious memes on Twitter. But it's not all fun and games. This tech can do some pretty scary stuff. Once it's widely available, seeing is believing will be a thing of the past. Experts say that it could become a serious threat to our security and democracy in the near future. And they can mess up the lives of everyday folks like you and me. Deepfakes do require a lot of existing photos or videos of a person, which is one reason public figures have been targeted. Good thing there aren't a bazillion photos of you on the internet anywhere. Wait. Imagine you're interviewing for a dream job, and suddenly you find yourself having to prove that a video of you stealing a phone from a Best Buy is actually a fake. Or say someone impersonates your grandmother's voice trying to get you to give them money. And ladies, I have even more bad news for you. So far, women are the most common victims of deepfakes. Usually, someone will splice the face of a woman they know into a pornographic or sexually provocative video to humiliate them. Sorry, ladies. One more thing to add to your list. And there's not a lot the victims can do once it's out there. Google allows you to add videos like these to its ban list so that the search engine blocks them in the search results. These are called involuntary synthetic pornographic imagery. But it's still not going to completely stop their spread online. And while good technical skills are required to create really convincing fakes, thanks to online communities, there are plenty of how-tos and other resources out there to get people started. People will even make them for you, some for as little as 20 bucks. So, if someone wants to harass you with a deepfake, they just need about 100 photos, which they can take right off your social media profiles, and some time and know-how, or just a little extra cash and the right connection. There are some possible defenses, though none are perfect. The most obvious is to use the same AI technology to detect phony videos. People and organizations are developing detection algorithms, but these methods will usually lag behind the technology used to create deepfakes. But even with this tech, how do you know what media to test? Remember that Lincoln photo I talked about earlier? It was only discovered to be a fake when a guy doing research for his book noticed that his mole was in the wrong place. So what can you do to avoid being fooled by deepfakes? To find out, I talked with Jabril, the host of a dope show called Jabril's. It's all about computer science.
So there are a few easy ways that you can spot deepfakes. One of the easiest ways is to recognize the framing. So you'll notice that most deepfakes are on a mugshot. So it's straight looking at the camera, hardly ever turn their face, no fast moves or anything. So with these algorithms, oftentimes the eyes and the teeth don't what we call converge to look realistic. So if those are looking fake, you might want to question it if it's deepfake or not. The last thing is the blending on the face. So with these algorithms, we're replacing faces on top of another one, and sometimes the color isn't matching, or you'll see like outline. Those are a few easy tips to notice a deepfake or not.
Dope, thank you.
Anytime, man.
Now, if a video passes all these tests, you gotta do some deeper investigating. Try to find another version of it online. Just like journalists, you wanna find multiple sources. Also, check some metadata. The YouTube data viewer shows you when a video was uploaded and gives you thumbnails for reverse image searching. But the best way to stop the spread of deepfakes is to slow down your impulse to share. It takes time from when a deepfake is published to when it can be detected. The hope is that the increased public awareness will create a lag time long enough to debunk deepfakes before they catch fire. And hey, maybe we can all demand that social media companies do more to combat this. So, what do you think? How will knowing more about deepfakes change the way you perceive images and videos online? Let us know in the comments below. And hey, check out Monstrum, a new show from PBS Digital Studios about monsters, myth, and lore. It's hosted by Dr. Emily Zarka, who is basically a doctor of monsters. That's a thing. Head to the link in the description to check out the show. And as always, like and subscribe and stay above the noise. Till next time, guys. Peace out.